today I'm going to go over installing Proxmox on this system, the 2013 Mac Pro, and go over what ports and functionality works with Proxmox on it, how the power consumption and thermals are like on this system, and to see if that's a reasonable way I can utilize the hardware on this system. If you're not familiar with these systems, the 2013 Mac Pro was Apple's top-of-the-line desktop sold from roughly late 2013 to early 2019. While I'd argue this system is pretty impressive when it comes to the amount of hardware they squeezed into this form factor, and Apple did a lot of interesting engineering if I take this system apart, including like round circuit boards and board-to-board interconnects with huge amounts of pins, a lot of people were very unhappy that the large desktops that Apple used to make for many years got replaced and got rid of all the I/O, internal hard drive expansion, CD or DVD drives on the system, and more, leaving many people unhappy as Apple's only option was a few Thunderbolt ports if you wanted to add more stuff later on. Internally, this system had a LGA 2011 Xeon, so an E5 V2 processor, four registered DDR3 memory slots, and dual AMD GPUs made for this system specifically that had the FirePro branding. My specific Mac Pro has a dual D700 GPUs on it, which were the highest end at their time, roughly equivalent to a 7970 on the Radeon side. The lower tier GPUs like a D500 is closest to a 7870 and kind of like a 7770 for the D300s. Unfortunately, my D700s have started to show some issues with some artifacting in macOS when I'm using the GPUs hard. And actually, this caused an issue as I was using this to edit all my YouTube videos for a little bit, and it messed up one of the exports. And someone commented, it looks weird. I'm like, ah, darn it, I messed up and didn't look at that part of the video. So this one's been mostly sitting around doing nothing because of that. This might have caused some of the issues I had with GPU pass-through I'm talking about in a bit, but I'm guessing that's not the case here, but let me know if you have access to one of these systems and can get different results than I am in that process. But back to the actual Proxmox part on the system and making it work. Luckily, Apple uses pretty standard Intel and other large manufacturer hardware inside those systems, and their custom firmware on these systems is capable of booting from almost any OS just fine, including Proxmox. So if I put in a Proxmox installer, it goes to the installer just fine. All the USB ports work fine. In my case, I chose to install it to an external USB SSD so I can leave my internal drive for macOS use in case I wanted to use that again. And it had no issues. Booted right up into Proxmox with the IP address on the screen, and I can just go to that IP and access the system. The dual onboard NICs work just fine at full speeds. USB 3 ports, I get the full speed I'd expect out of those ports. And video out works just fine on that system. The one main compatibility and oddity issue I had is with Thunderbolt. I don't have a lot of Thunderbolt devices laying around, but I have this little Thunderbolt drive, and plugging it into the Thunderbolt 2 ports don't work, but if I use the USB port on this drive, it does work just fine. Now, when it comes to just general VM use and using it, there's not too much to say, because it's almost identical to any other system with the same hardware inside of it. Unfortunately, I don't have an identical workstation PC, but all the performance clocks and other numbers I got seem to be nearly identical to those other systems out there. I was getting about 2.7 gigahertz on all cores using something like Prime 95 that was pushing AVX really hard. I was getting a little bit higher clock speed, like 2.9 on all core with a lighter workload like stress maxing out all of the cores. And I was getting about 85C on the CPU cores when I was pushing it to its limit, with the fan barely spinning up to only about 1,000 RPM. Looking at wall power consumption on the system, it was sitting at about 220 watts with my CPU being maxed out. And with no load or a completely idle system with no VMs running, it was running at about 100 watts. 100 watts seems like quite a bit of power consumption for a basic LGA 2011 system like this, as I've actually had dual socket versions of this same platform running at less power idle. Something tells me these GPUs aren't completely off, and no idle power when no running memory in no basic form and other things is likely hurting power consumption. I was thinking perhaps I could disable one of the GPUs to save power, but due to the way they have these interesting bus bars and board-to-board interconnects, I'm afraid something weird would happen if I unplugged just one of them, but that might be one option to look into. Speaking of GPUs, let's talk about GPU pass-through and how I tried to use it on this system and my successes and failures. So I started off by doing GPU pass-through like I would on any other system, going into the boot options on the system and turning on Intel IO MMU equals on, and then rebooting the system once that's been applied. I will note that Apple doesn't have a standard like BIOS or firmware settings you can access like most PCs can on this system. But for most options like virtualization, leave it on all the systems. So for most all Proxmox use, there's no need to actually edit any of those firmware settings anyways. But once I've been rebooted, the system was complaining that I needed to have unsafe interrupts turned on. So I added this parameter to my boot options. And then it was happy and said that with unsafe interrupts enabled, I can do pass-through on this system. So I first started off by just passing through one of these GPUs to a Windows VM like I typically would try to do. And upon passing through my GPU to my Windows VM, I got my little Microsoft Basic Display device. So now I need to install a driver so I can utilize my GPU, which seems easier than it is in this case. Since these are a custom version of AMD FirePro GPUs for only this system, I can't use the standard FirePro drivers that would work for a FirePro card using the same die that would be found in a PC. I also can't use the Radeon drivers. So I'm stuck with a relatively old and limited version of drivers that are made for Apple Bootcamp systems if I was running Windows on bare metal on this system. But in a VM, it's even weirder, because if I try to run the Bootcamp drivers, it fails very early into the install. And I'm guessing it's checking for something of like, is it actually a Mac hardware I'm running on? And that failed, so it just says I can't install on the system. So I tried installing something like a Radeon 7970 hardware or those FirePro drivers, which would have the same die of silicon in it. And in both of their cases, the drivers installed and went to a reboot now prompt. And I went and rebooted the VM, and even with the driver installed, it still said the Microsoft Basic device was there, so it looks like it just isn't able to use the device, which makes sense because it wasn't the correct driver and it probably isn't on the whitelisted approved GPUs you should be using with that driver, but that's the only driver I seem to be able to use. So Windows seems to be a non-option when it comes on this system. So maybe a macOS VM with the GPU pass-through would work correctly. That's the OS it's designed to run on, right? So I tried installing a macOS VM, installed just fine, and I installed a VM version that would be compatible with this hardware running on bare metal. And it shows the GPU in system information. It was just a very basic, it's an AMD GPU, and that's it. This is all the information I saw, and it doesn't output anything to a screen connected to the HDMI port to the correct GPU. It doesn't seem to use any hardware acceleration. It seems to detect it, but not be able to use it. I don't know what's going on under the hood or causing those specific issues. And I really don't know enough about playing with graphics and macOS to get anything more out of it. But we have one more major OS to play with. In this case, Linux. Installing Linux on the system would show that it's a Tahiti core, which I'd expect that the same, it's a 7900 XT or one of the FirePro based GPUs. And running Radeon top shows that the GPU exists, but seems to show odd data, with things like some of the data missing and not showing that it has any VRAM. I tried playing a little bit with a little bit of the AMD proprietary drivers that would enable OpenCL support, which is likely what I'd want to use in a command line VM, and none of that worked. I also tried running it as the only graphics card with a monitor connected to it, and since the GPU by default is going to be like the Proxmox main GPU, it removed all the Proxmox console startup information on the system. It seemed to flicker the screen on and off like it was switching modes and then showed black forever and didn't have any more display outputs. Can't use that as main GPU. So while I'm far from the most knowledgeable on how to do GPU pass through and all the possible tweaks and messing with drivers to make it work, it seems like if you want a simple GPU pass-through experience, this system doesn't give it to you. And if you know some trick that might make it possible, I'd love to see it work. But on the more practical side, GPU pass-through on this system I don't think makes a lot of sense either. These GPUs are over a decade old now, which means that most software has dropped support for it. Apple and AMD's Bootcamp drivers don't support these for quite a while, causing quite a bit of issues. AMD themselves for Windows has stopped most support for first-gen GCN hardware, and even open source projects like RockM for compute has dropped compute support. And while I'd love to see GPU pass-through work because I like seeing weird configurations that probably should never happen work on this system, in a more practical standpoint, I don't see using these GPUs to be a major improvement for a lot of workloads. These are over a decade old now, which means a lot of software support has gone away for them. Projects like RockM don't support this first-gen GCN hardware pretty much at all. AMD has dropped support for these GPUs in Windows, so they aren't doing major driver updates on these systems anymore. And Apple themselves is pretty forward moving towards use our own M-series silicon, and we're adding features that only works on that silicon, not older hardware like this. And even if compatibility wasn't an issue, the performance of these GPUs really isn't great. And even if you only want to use things like encoding blocks for video on these GPUs, they don't support most modern codecs very well and likely have quite poor quality. One other disadvantage of these GPUs is they seem to be fairly power hungry. Modern silicon has gotten significantly more power efficient, and this system using about 100 watts at idle is quite a bit for what is now relatively slow hardware. While I think it's a cute form factor that I'd love to see sitting around running and doing something useful, I can't justify spending 100 watts on what is now a decade-old 12-core processor with relatively limited memory compatibility. And if you actually want to use one of these systems in your home lab, you're paying a pretty hefty Apple tax for a system that Proxmox can't take full advantage of. But let me know what you think of this hardware. What would you want to use it for in something like a home lab? Or what weird use do you think this strange Apple system should find its way into? I use it as a fun occasional Mac OS system, and I've actually been using it to host most of the streams and a lot of the videos I've been doing at my other set recently. But let me know if you think there's a better or more interesting use I missed for this system. Thanks for watching this video, and I'm looking forward to reading the comments about your thoughts on this interesting system and how it does running Proxmox.